Avengers Endgame. Avengers Endgame is a 2019 American superhero film based on the Marvel comic superhero team The Avengers, produced by Marvel Studios and distributed by Walt Disney Studios Motion Pictures. It is the sequel to 2012's The Avengers, 2015's Avengers, Age of Ultron and 2018's Avengers, Infinity War, and the 22nd film in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, MCU. Serving as the conclusion to the Infinity Saga, the film is directed by Anthony and Joe Russo, written by Christopher Markus and Stephen McFeely, and features an ensemble cast including Robert Downey Jr., Chris Evans, Mark Ruffalo, Chris Hemsworth, Scarlett Johansson, Jeremy Renner, Don Cheadle, Paul Rudd, Brie Larson, Karen Gillan, Danai Gurira, Bradley Cooper, and Josh Brolin. In the film, the surviving members of the Avengers and their allies work to reverse the damage caused by Thanos in Infinity War. The film was announced in October 2014 as Avengers, Infinity War, Part 2. The Russo brothers came on board to direct in April 2015, and by May, Markus and McFeely signed on to script the film. In July 2016, Marvel removed the title, referring to it simply as Untitled Avengers Film. Filming began in August 2017 at Pinewood Atlanta Studios in Fayette County, Georgia, shooting back-to-back with Infinity War, and ended in January 2018. Additional filming took place in the metro and downtown Atlanta areas and New York. The official title was revealed in December 2018, with an estimated budget of $356 million. It is one of the most expensive films ever made. Avengers Endgame was highly anticipated, and Disney backed the film with extensive marketing campaigns. It premiered in Los Angeles on the 22nd of April, 2019, and was theatrically released in the United States on the 26th of April, 2019, in IMAX and 3D. The film received highly positive review with praises for its screenplay, direction, acting, musical score, entertainment value, visual effects and emotional weight, with critics lauding its culmination of the 22-film story. It also broke numerous box office records and has grossed over $2.10 billion worldwide, surpassing Infinity War's entire theatrical run in just 11 days and becoming the highest-grossing film of 2019, as well as the second-highest-grossing film of all time. Plot: 3 weeks after Thanos used the Infinity Gauntlet to disintegrate half of all life, Carol Danvers rescues Tony Stark and Nebula and returns them to Earth. They reunite with the remaining Avengers: Bruce Banner, Steve Rogers, Rocket, Thor, Natasha Romanoff, and James Rhodes, to retake the Infinity Stones and reverse the disintegrations. They find Thanos, now a crippled farmer living on an unguarded planet, but discover that he has already destroyed them to prevent further use. An enraged Thor beheads Thanos. 5 years later, Scott Lang escapes from the Quantum Realm. At the Avengers compound, he explains that he experienced only 5 hours while trapped, theorizing that the Quantum Realm could allow time travel. The three ask Stark to help them retrieve the stones from the past to reverse Thanos' actions in the present. Stark refuses to help out of fear of losing his daughter Morgan. After talking with his wife, Pepper Potts, Stark relents and with Banner, successfully builds a time machine. Any changes in the past create a branched alternative reality in the past, instead of affecting the current reality's present. Banner and Rocket go to New Asgard, the Asgardian refugees' new home in Norway, to recruit Thor, now an overweight drunk despondent over his failure. Romanoff recruits Clint Barton, now a ruthless vigilante after his family was disintegrated. Banner, Lang, Rogers, and Stark travel to New York City in 2012. Banner visits the Sanctum Sanctorum and convinces the Ancient One to give him the Time Stone. Rogers successfully retrieves the Mind Stone. Stark and Lang's interference inadvertently allows Loki to escape with the Space Stone. In a last-minute decision, both Rogers and Stark decide to take a risk by time-traveling into the past. Rogers and Stark travel to SHIELD headquarters in 1970, where Stark encounters a young Howard Stark. They then manage to steal an earlier version of the Space Stone. Rocket and Thor travel to Asgard in 2013 and extract the Reality Stone from Jane Foster, and also retrieve Thor's hammer Mjolnir. Nebula and Rhodes travel to Morag in 2014 and steal the Power Stone before Peter Quill can. Rhodes returns to the present with the Power Stone, but Nebula is unable to return when her cybernetic implants interface with those of her past self. Through this connection, the Thanos of 2014 learns of his future success and the Avengers attempts to undo it. Thanos captures Nebula and sends past Nebula to the present day disguised as her future self. Barton and Romanoff travel to Vormir, where the Soul Stone's keeper, the Red Skull, reveals it can only be acquired by sacrificing someone they love. Romanoff sacrifices herself, allowing Barton to obtain the Soul Stone. Reuniting in the present, the Avengers fit the stones into a Stark-created gauntlet. Banner dons the gauntlet and resurrects all those whom Thanos had disintegrated. Past Nebula uses the time machine to transport past Thanos and his warship to the present. Thanos attacks the Avengers compound. Nebula convinces past Gamora to turn against Thanos, and kills her past self. Stark, Rogers and Thor battle Thanos but are overmatched. A restored Stephen Strange arrives with other sorcerers, the restored Avengers and Guardians of the Galaxy, as well as the armies of Wakanda, Asgard, and the Ravagers to fight Thanos and his army alongside Danvers. After overpowering Thor, Rogers, and Danvers, Thanos seizes the gauntlet, but Stark takes the stones and disintegrates Thanos and his army. Stark dies as a result of the injuries sustained from use of the stones. Following Stark's funeral, Thor appoints Valkyrie as the ruler of New Asgard and joins the Guardians of the Galaxy. Rogers returns the Infinity Stones to their original places in time, and remains in the past to be with Peggy Carter in a branched reality. In the present, an elderly Steve Rogers gives his shield to Sam Wilson. Cast Robert Downey Jr. as Tony Stark Iron Man, the benefactor of the Avengers, with electromechanical suits of armor of his own making. According to directors Joe and Anthony Russo, Downey was one of the few actors to read the entire screenplay for the film. Chris Evans as Steve Rogers, Captain America, the leader of the Avengers, a World War II veteran. He was enhanced to the peak of human physicality by an experimental serum and frozen in suspended animation before waking up in the modern world. Mark Ruffalo as Bruce Banner Hulk, an Avenger and a genius scientist who, because of exposure to gamma radiation, possesses enhanced strength and a monstrous appearance. In this film, Banner has managed to balance his two sides with gamma experimentation, enabling him to balance his intelligence with the Hulk's strength and physical stature, based on the Professor Hulk comic book identity. This concludes a character arc that was established in Thor, Ragnarok and continued in Avengers, Infinity War. Chris Hemsworth as Thor, an Avenger and the King of New Asgard, based on the Norse mythological deity of the same name. Thor now wields a mystical axe known as Stormbreaker, after the destruction of his hammer Mjolnir in Thor, Ragnarok. In the film, Thor has become an overweight, drunken ruler of Asgard's refugees in Tonsberg, Norway. Referencing this drastic character change, Hemsworth said, "I just had an opinion. I wanted to do something different this time. Each film I've wanted to book, in particular, the last couple, and they were on board," and added, "We shot for many hours and days and discussed how far could we push Thor, and what we could do different." Anthony Russo added, "Even though there's a lot of fun to be had in the movie with his physical condition, it's not a gag, it's a manifestation of where he is on a character level, and we think it's one of the most relatable aspects of him. I mean, it's a very common sort of response to depression and pain." Scarlett Johansson as Natasha Romanoff, Black Widow, a highly trained spy, a member of the Avengers, and a former agent of SHIELD. Jeremy Renner as Clint Barton, Hawkeye, a master archer, an Avenger, and a former agent of SHIELD. Barton has a new outfit in the film, visually similar to that of Ronin from the comics. Don Cheadle as James Rhodey Rhodes, War Machine, a former officer in the US Air Force and Avenger who operates the War Machine armor. Paul Rudd as Scott Lang, Ant-Man, an Avenger and a former petty criminal who acquired a suit that allows him to shrink or grow in scale and increase in strength. Lang is portrayed by twins Baslow and Lone Leclerc as a baby, by Jackson Dunn at age 12, and by Lee Moore at age 93. This was Moore's final film before his death. Brie Larson as Carol Danvers, Captain Marvel, an Avenger and an ex-US Air Force pilot whose DNA was altered during an accident, which imbues her with the powers of superhuman strength, energy projection, and flight. Co-screenwriter Christopher Markus stated that Danvers' powers are on a scale that has not previously existed in the MCU and likened her personality to Rogers, which is sort of a person who's right and knows they're right and doesn't really want to hear it when you tell them they're wrong. Larson filmed her scenes for Endgame before beginning work on her solo film Captain Marvel, which was released first. Captain Marvel directors Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck were present for the filming of her scenes in Endgame and gave Danvers' characterization in the film their blessing. Karen Gillan as Nebula, an Avenger and the adopted daughter of Thanos who was raised with Gamora as siblings. Danai Gurira as Okoye, an Wakandan traditionalist from the Border Tribe, who is the head of the Dora Milaje, Wakanda's all-female special forces and T'Challa's bodyguards. Benedict Wong as Wong, a master of the mystic arts and associate of Stephen Strange. Jon Favreau as Harold Happy Hogan, the former head of security for Stark Industries and Tony Stark's driver and bodyguard. Bradley Cooper as Rocket, an Avenger and a member of the Guardians of the Galaxy who is a genetically engineered raccoon-based bounty hunter and mercenary, and is a master of weapons and battle tactics. Sean Gunn was again the stand-in for Rocket during filming, with his acting and expressions serving as motion reference for the character. Gwyneth Paltrow as Virginia Pepper Potts, Stark's wife and the CEO of Stark Industries, who wears a powered exosuit of armor in the film, her own variation of a suit of Iron Man's armor, similar to that of Rescue from the comics. Paltrow said this would be her final major appearance in the MCU. Josh Brolin as Thanos, an intergalactic warlord from Titan who collected the 6 Infinity Stones to impose his will on all life in the universe. Joe Russo said that after Thanos was successful in Avengers Infinity War, he is now done. He did it. He's retired. In addition to providing the voice for the character, Brolin performed motion capture on set. Several actors whose characters died during the events of Infinity War reprise their roles in Endgame, including Benedict Cumberbatch as Dr. Stephen Strange, Chadwick Boseman as T'Challa Black Panther, Tom Holland as Peter Parker Spider-Man, Zoe Saldana as Gamora, Evangeline Lilly as Hope Van Dyne Wasp, Elizabeth Olsen as Wanda Maximoff Scarlet Witch, Anthony Mackie as Sam Wilson Falcon, Sebastian Stan as Bucky Barnes Winter Soldier, Tom Hiddleston as Loki, Tom Clemente as Mantis, Dave Bautista as Drax the Destroyer, Letitia Wright as Shuri, Michael Douglas as Hank Pym, Michelle Pfeiffer as Janet Van Dyne, Kobe Smulders as Maria Hill, Linda Cardellini as Laura Barton, Tom Vaughn, Lola as Ebony Maw, Vin Diesel as Groot, Chris Pratt as Peter Quill Star-Lord, Samuel L. Jackson as Nick Fury, Michael James Shaw as Corvus Glaive, and Terry Notary as Cull Obsidian. Monique Ganderton provides the motion capture performance for Proxima Midnight, who was previously motion captured by Carrie Coon. Also reprising their roles from past MCU films are Tessa Thompson as Valkyrie, Rene Russo as Frigga, John Slattery as Howard Stark, Tilda Swinton as the Ancient One, Hayley Atwell as Peggy Carter, Marissa Tomei as May Parker, Taika Waititi as Korg, Angela Bassett as Ramonda, William Hurt as Thaddeus Ross, Winston Duke as M'Baku, Maximiliano Hernandez as Jasper Sitwell, Frank Grillo as Brock Rumlow, Jacob Batalon as Ned, Robert Redford as Alexander Pierce, Ross Marquand as Red Skull, Kerry Condon as the voice of Stark Suit AI, FRIDAY, Callan Mulvey as Jack Rollins, Sean Gunn as Kraglin, and Ty Simpkins as Harley Keener. Natalie Portman appears as Jane Foster through unused footage from Thor, The Dark World and new voiceover that Portman recorded for when Foster appears talking in the distance. James D'Arcy reprises his role as Edwin Jarvis from the MCU television series Agent Carter, marking the first time a character introduced in an MCU television series appears in an MCU film. Additionally, Hiroyuki Sanada portrays Akihiko, a Yakuza boss operating in Tokyo who opposes Barton. Lexi Rabe portrays Morgan Stark, Tony and Pepper's daughter. Catherine Langford was cast to portray an older Morgan, but her scene was deleted from the film. Emma Furman portrays present-day Cassie Lang, Scott's daughter. Avengers co-creator Stan Lee has a posthumous cameo in the film, appearing digitally de-aged as a car driver in 1970. This is his final cameo appearance in film. Two of the stars of the Russo brothers work on the television series Community, Ken Jeong and Yvette Nicole Brown. Cameo as a storage facility guard and a SHIELD agent in an elevator, respectively. Co-director Joe Russo, credited as Gozi Agbo, has a cameo appearance as a man grieving the sudden loss of a loved one, which is the first time an openly homosexual character has been portrayed in an MCU film. Joe's daughters Ava and Lyra respectively portray Barton's daughter Lila and a fan of Hulk. Thanos creator Jim Starlin also appears as a grieving man. Production main article. Production of Avengers, Infinity War and Avengers, Endgame in October 2014. Marvel announced a two-part sequel to Age of Ultron, titled Avengers, Infinity War. Part 1 was scheduled to be released on the 4th of May, 2018, with Part 2 scheduled for the 3rd of May, 2019. In April 2015, Marvel announced that Anthony and Joe Russo would direct both parts of Avengers, Infinity War, with back-to-back filming expected to begin in 2016. Also in the month, Kevin Feige said the films were titled as two parts of a single film because they such shared elements, but he would not actually describe them as one story that's cut in half. I would say it's going to be two distinct movies. By May 2015, Christopher Markus and Stephen McFeely signed on to write the screenplays for both parts of the film. The following May, the Russos revealed that they would be retitling the two films, to further remove the misconception that the films were one large film split in two, with Joe stating, "The intention is we will change. We just haven't come up with yet." In July 2016, Marvel removed the film's title, simply referring to it as Untitled Avengers Film. Feige and the Russo brothers indicated the title was being withheld because it would give away plot details for this film and Infinity War. Principal photography began on the 10th of August, 2017, under the working title Mary Lou 2, at Pinewood Atlanta Studios in Fayette County, Georgia, with Trent Okoloch serving as director of photography. The film, along with Infinity War, were shot using IMAX-ery 2D cameras, thus marking the first time that a Hollywood feature film was shot entirely with IMAX digital cameras. Also in the month, filming occurred in the Gulch area of downtown Atlanta, near the Five Points MARTA station, and Piedmont Park. Feige explained that the films were originally scheduled to be filmed simultaneously but were ultimately shot back to back, as it became too complicated to cross-board them like that, and we found ourselves, again, something would always pay the price. We wanted to be able to focus and shoot one movie and then focus and shoot another movie. Anthony Russo originally felt it made more sense to shoot the film simultaneously due to financial and logistical reasons considering the large number of cast members, even though each part is its own distinct film, and suggested that some days we'll be shooting the first movie and some days we'll be shooting the second movie, just jumping back and forth. Production wrapped on the 11th of January, 2018. Although additional filming took place in Dutchess and Ulster counties in New York in June 2018, reshoots began by the 7th of September, 2018, and concluded on the 12th of October, 2018. More reshoots occurred in January 2019. Evans and Hemsworth each earned $15 million for the film. On the 7th of December, 2018, with the release of the film's first trailer, the title was revealed to be Avengers: Endgame, while also moving its release date in the United States to the 26th of April, 2019. Visual effects for the film were created by Industrial Light and Magic, Weta Digital, DNEG, Framastore, Cinezit, Digital Domain, Rise, Lola VFX, Cantina Creative, Capital T, Technicolor VFX, and Territory Studio. Jeffrey Ford and Matthew Schmidt served as the film's editors. Music main article, Avengers, Endgame. Soundtrack. In June 2016, Alan Silvestri, who composed the score for the Avengers, was revealed to be returning to score both Infinity War and Endgame. The Russos started working with Silvestri on the Endgame score in early November 2018, and it was completed in late March 2019. Silvestri described the score as having the most versatile tone of the franchise, ranging from thunderous percussion and powerful brass for the action sequences to minimalist, jazz-inspired music for Ant-Man and the Quantum Realm. Silvestri reprises his themes from the previous Avengers films and Captain America, the First Avenger, such as material he wrote for Thanos and the Infinity Stones in Infinity War. He found writing the music to end Captain America's story poignant, since he had been on this journey with him since the beginning. The film's soundtrack also uses Christoph Beck's Ant-Man theme, Michael Giacchino's Doctor Strange theme, and Pina Toprak's Captain Marvel theme. Additionally, the songs Come and Get Your Love by Redbone and It's Been a Long, Long Time by Jewel Stein and Sammy Khan are used. After previously being heard in Guardians of the Galaxy and Captain America, The Winter Soldier, respectively. A soundtrack album featuring Silvestri's score was released by Hollywood Records digitally on the 26th of April, 2019, with a physical release on the 24th of May. The marketing campaign for Endgame is the largest for any Marvel Studios film, surpassing $200 million and beating Infinity War's $150 million campaign. Promotional partners include Stand Up to Cancer, MasterCard, Ulta Beauty, the Audi e-tron GT concept car, which is also featured in the film, McDonald's, Geico, Coca-Cola, Google, General Mills, Hertz, Ziploc, Oppo, and Synchrony Financial. A year prior to the film's release, Jermaine Lussier of IO9 spoke on the approach Marvel might have to take in marketing the film, given the end of Infinity War, which sees many established characters die. He questioned if those characters would appear on posters and in toy campaigns and if the actors portraying them would participate in press events leading up to the film's release. Lussier felt Disney and Marvel could focus on the original Avengers team members, who make up the majority of the living characters, but noted it would be more beneficial to show the return of the dead characters, which would build a mystery and curiosity about how they come back. It could create a whole new level of interest about the film while having all the stars front and center, as they should be. In June 2018, Feige spoke to this, stating that these dead characters would not be featured in any marketing for the film, though the decision regarding that could change. He presented a behind-the-scenes video from the film at Sign Europe, and said that the official marketing campaign for the film would begin at the end of 2018 with the announcement of the film's title then. In early December 2018, ahead of the first trailer's release, Graham McMillan of The Hollywood Reporter spoke to the fevered anticipation surrounding it. McMillan felt what was so remarkable about the anticipation was that it was mostly fan-created, without noticeable direction from Marvel or the filmmakers involved, and that the amount of knowledge surrounding the film without any type of promotion was a kind of brand awareness that most studios would kill for. Because of this, McMillan urged Marvel not to release any trailers for the film, since the advanced level of enthusiasm that's already out there for the movie is only likely to build as it gets closer to the film's release. That said, he added that the eventual release of the trailer would take away the scrudding's cat-esque position it currently enjoys, as it was almost guaranteed to disappoint fans, who have by this point built up their own personal trailers filled with whatever moments are essential to their enjoyment of a good teaser. The first trailer for the film was released on the 7th of December, 2018. Dustin Sandoval, Vice President of Digital Marketing for Marvel Studios, stated the marketing team actively made the choice not to include the title or hashtag of the movie in our trailer posts so fans could see it at the end reveal without it being spelled. Richard Newby, also of The Hollywood Reporter, felt, while not much new was revealed in the trailer, it offers a somber glimpse of a universe made unrecognizable and lets the viewer sit, rightfully so, with the ending of Avengers, Infinity War and our questions of loss. Newby also noted how the trailer calls back to beginnings of the MCU. The visual language used in the trailer does a great service by highlighting these characters' humble beginnings, and concluded it leaves viewers with just as many questions as we had before. Austin Goslin of Polygon pointed out that the title not only references a line Doctor Strange tells Tony Stark in Infinity War, but also a line spoken by Stark in Avengers: Age of Ultron. Goslin, who felt this was probably an accident, said, "The scene surrounding this line in Age of Ultron is one of the most important ones in the movie. Things look dark, and the group of heroes face an enemy they don't think they can defeat. As such, the Endgame trailer mirrors this perfectly and shows us that the Avengers' two most prominent characters are who they've always been. Iron Man, a pessimist who keeps fighting no matter how hopeless things look, and Captain America, an optimist who believes that nothing is hopeless when the world's heroes fight together." The trailer was viewed 289 million times in its first 24 hours, becoming the most viewed trailer in that time period, surpassing the record of Avengers: Infinity War, 230 million views. The trailer also set a record for Twitter conversation for a film trailer in the first 24 hours, generating 549,000 mentions. By the 3rd of January, 2019, Box Office revealed their trailer impact metric service indicated approximately 77-78% of people surveyed who viewed the Endgame trailer in the past 3 weeks expressed interest in seeing the film. In the 3 weeks it was measured by trailer impact, it was number one for all, and had the top 2% of respondents express interest in seeing the film since the service's introduction in March 2018. The second trailer for the film, along with the theatrical release poster, was released on the 14th of March, 2019. The poster, featuring 13 characters, had 12 of those actors listed on the top billing, with Danai Gurira excluded, despite Gurira's name appearing in the poster's bottom billing block along with Benedict Wong, Jon Favreau, and Gwyneth Paltrow, none of whom were featured on the poster. Her exclusion in the top billing prompted criticism from fans. Katrana Radulovic of Polygon noted how an actor is credited on the poster is a complex process, and the omission of Gurira in the top billing was less of a conscious decision than the ramifications of dealing with agents, fees, and movie star demands. However, later in the day Marvel Studios released an updated poster with Gurira's name in the top billing. The second trailer was viewed 268 million times in the first 24 hours, becoming the second most viewed trailer in that time period. Behind the film's first trailer, release Avengers Endgame had its world premiere at the Los Angeles Convention Center on the 22nd of April, 2019. Disney converted the convention center's Hall K for the film's premiere, working with Dolby and QSC Audio to install a 70-foot, 21 meters, screen, Dolby Vision projectors, and a Dolby Atmos sound system. The convention center also held the premiere's red carpet arrival and after party. It was released in China, Australia, and other parts of Asia and Europe on the 24th of April, 2019. In the United Kingdom on the 25th of April. In the United States and India on the 26th of April. And Russia on the 29th of April in IMAX and 3D. It was originally scheduled to be released in the United States on the 3rd of May, 2019. In Russia it was controversially ordered by the government to postpone the film premiere in order to promote Russian movies. Reception Box Office Main Article. List of box office records set by Avengers Endgame as of the 5th of May, 2019. Avengers Endgame has grossed $619.70 million in the United States and Canada, and $1.569 billion in other territories, for a worldwide total of $2.189 billion. It is the highest grossing film of 2019, as well as the highest grossing superhero film of all time, second highest grossing film of all time worldwide, and ninth highest in the United States and Canada. It is also the highest grossing MCU film and the highest grossing film worldwide released by Walt Disney Studios, surpassing Star Wars: The Force Awakens. The film had a worldwide opening of $1.20 billion, the biggest of all time and nearly double Infinity War's previous record of $640.50 million. It was also the fastest film to ever eclipse the $1 billion mark, doing so in just 5 days, less than half what it took Infinity War. Deadline Hollywood estimated the film would break even just 5 days after its release, which is unheard of for a major studio tentpole during its opening weekend. The website estimated it would turn a net profit of $650 million, accounting for production budgets, P&A, talent participations and other costs, with box office grosses and ancillary revenues from home media. On the 4th of May, the film's earnings at the global box office passed the entire theatrical run of Infinity War and became the fastest film to ever gross $2 billion worldwide, amassing the amount in only 11 days. Beating Avatar that did so in 47 days. It also became the fifth film in cinematic history to surpass the threshold, after Avatar, Titanic, Star Wars, The Force Awakens, and Infinity War. Pre-sale records in late December 2018. Endgame was named the second most anticipated 2019 film by IMDb behind Captain Marvel, the most anticipated blockbuster of 2019 according to the ticketing service Fandango, and the most anticipated overall film by Atom Tickets. Due to the high demand when pre-sale tickets became available in the US on the 2nd of April, 2019. Customers on both Atom Tickets and Fandango experienced long wait times and system delays, while AMC Theater's website and app crashed completely for several hours. The same day, Fandango announced the film became its top-selling pre-sale title for the first 24 hours, topping Star Wars: The Force Awakens' previous record in just 6 hours. Atom said the film was also the website's best-selling first-day film, outselling Aquaman by 4 times, and Regal Cinemas reported that Endgame had sold more tickets in its first 8 hours than Infinity War did in its entire first week. The film grossed $120 million in pre-sales alone. The day prior to the film's release, Fandango announced it was its biggest pre-selling title of all time, beating The Force Awakens, with over 8,000 sold-out showtimes across the country. In India, the film sold 1 million tickets in just 1 day for the English, Hindi, Tamil, and Telugu language screenings. 18 tickets were sold every second. In China, pre-sale tickets became available on the 12th of April and sold a record 1 million tickets in just 6 hours, outselling Infinity War's first 24-hour total within the first hour, and made ¥114.50 million, $770 million just from pre-sales. United States and Canada on the 4th of April, industry tracking projected the film would gross $200-$250 million domestically during its opening weekend. Although some insiders saw those figures as conservative and expected a $260-$300 million debut, by the week of its release, domestic estimates had risen to $260-$270 million, with some insiders still suggesting a $300 million debut was possible. The film played in 4,662 theaters, 410 of which were in IMAX. It is the widest release ever, surpassing the record of Despicable Me 3's 4,529 theaters. Avengers Endgame earned $357.10 million in its opening weekend, breaking Infinity War's record by nearly $100 million. It also set records for Friday, $156.70 million, including $60 million from Thursday night previews, Saturday, $111.50 million and Sunday $90.40 million totals, as well as was more of a total gross alone than the previous box office high of all films combined, $314 million. The film then made $36.70 million on Monday and $33.40 million on Tuesday, both the third highest of all time. In its second weekend, the film made $145.80 million, the second best sophomore frame ever, for a 10-day total of $619.70 million. It was the fastest film to ever pass the $600 million milestone, beating The Force Awakens 12 days and less than half the 26 days it took Infinity War. Other territories internationally, Endgame was projected to gross around $680 million over its first 5 days for a global debut of $850-$950 million. The film was initially projected to gross $250-$280 million in China in its opening weekend, but made a record ¥107.50 million, $719 million in the country on its first day, including ¥26.80 million, $180 million from midnight, 3 a.m. and 6 a.m. screenings, beating the Fate of the Furious previous record of $9.10 million. Due to the record-breaking first day, partnered with word of mouth, with a 9.1 on local review aggregator Dubbin and a 9.3 on ticket website Mayoan, debut projections were increased to over $300 million. Overall, the film made $169 million on the first day from international countries, the highest total of all time. Its largest markets after China were India, $9 million, South Korea, $8.40 million. The largest non-holiday single-day gross ever, Australia, $7.10 million, France, $6 million and Italy, $5.80 million. Like domestically, the film ended up overperforming and debuted to $866.50 million overseas. Not only was it the highest foreign amount ever, but it was single-handedly more than Infinity War's global opening of $640 million. Its largest markets, every one of which set the record for best ever opening in the country, were China, $330.50 million, RMB 2.22 billion, The United Kingdom, $53.80 million. South Korea, $47.40 million. Mexico, $33.10 million. Australia, $30.80 million. Brazil, $26 million. Spain, $13.30 million. And Japan, $13 million. It also made $21.60 million over its first 4 days in Russia after a delay of its premiere that was caused by the Russian government. In its first week, the film's top five largest international markets were China, $459.40 million, the United Kingdom, $68.20 million, South Korea, $60.30 million, Mexico, $48.60 million, and India, $40.90 million. A week after its release, it became the highest-grossing foreign film of all time in China and India. In its second weekend, the film's running total passed $1.569 billion from international markets, passing Titanic as the second highest film overseas of all time. Critical response on review aggregator Rotten Tomatoes. The film holds a 95% approval rating based on 434 reviews, with an average rating of the 29th of August 2010. The website's critics' consensus reads, "Exciting, entertaining, and emotionally impactful. Avengers Endgame does whatever it takes to deliver a satisfying finale to Marvel's epic Infinity Saga." Metacritic, which uses a weighted average, assigned the film a score of 78 out of 100 based on 56 critics, indicating generally favorable reviews. Audiences polled for CinemaScore gave the film a rare A+ grade, the third Marvel film to earn the score after The Avengers and Black Panther, while those at PostTrack gave it 5 out of 5 stars and a definite recommend of 85%. Writing for NPR, Glenn Weldon gave the film a positive review and found the film to be a worthy sequel to its predecessor, stating, "The Russo's decision to stick close to the experiences of the remaining Avengers proves a rewarding one, as they've expressly constructed the film as an extended victory lap for the Marvel Cinematic Universe writ large. Got a favorite character from any Marvel movie over the past decade, no matter how obscure? Prepare to get serviced, fan." Peter Travers, in his review for Rolling Stone magazine, gave the film 4 out of 5 stars, saying, "You don't have to make jokes about the cliché time travel plot. The film is ready, willing and able to make its own, with Back to the Future coming in for a serious ribbing." Peter Debruge of Variety wrote, "After the must-see showdown that was Infinity War, the Russo brothers deliver a more fan-facing 3-hour follow-up, rewarding loyalty to Marvel Cinematic Universe." J.R. Kinnard of Pop Matters wrote, "Big budget action filmmaking doesn't get much better than this." Todd McCarthy of The Hollywood Reporter said, "Hat comes across most strongly here. Oddly enough for an effects-driven comic book-derived film, is the character acting, especially from Downey, Ruffalo, Evans, Hemsworth, Brolin and Paul Rudd." Richard Roper, writing for the Chicago Sun-Times, gave the film 4 stars and called it the undisputed champion when it comes to emotional punch. Roper went on to praise the funny, well-paced, smart, expertly rendered screenplay by Christopher Markus and Stephen McFeely, crisp direction from Anthony Russo and Joe Russo, and the universally stellar performances. The New York Times reviewer A.O. Scott gave the film a positive though guarded review, stating, "Endgame is a monument to adequacy, a fitting capstone to an enterprise that figured out how to be good enough for enough people enough of the time. Not that it's really over. Of course, Disney and Marvel are still working out new wrinkles in the time-money continuum. But the Russos do provide the sense of an ending, a chance to appreciate what has been done before the timelines reset and we all get back to work." Justin Chang of the Los Angeles Times wrote that Avengers Endgame achieves and earns its climactic surge of feeling, even as it falls just short of real catharsis. Richard Brody, writing for the New Yorker magazine on the 26th of April, 2019, gave the film a critical review, opining that the good acting was not matched by comparable skill from the directors. He said, "The Russos have peculiarly little sense of visual pleasure, little sense of beauty, little sense of metaphor, little aptitude for texture or composition. Their spectacular conceit is purely one of scale, which is why their finest moments are quiet and dramatic ones." Anthony Lane of The New Yorker gave the film a compromising review, finding it to be overdeveloped and overawed, stating, The one thing you do need to know about Avengers Endgame is that it runs for a little over 3 hours, and that you can easily duck out during the middle hour, do some shopping, and slip back into your seat for the climax. You won't have missed a thing. Future further information. List of Marvel Cinematic Universe films future in May 2018. Disney CEO Bob Iger said of Marvel's plans beyond Endgame, "I'm guessing we will try our hand at what I'll call a new franchise beyond Avengers. But that doesn't necessarily mean you won't see more Avengers down the road. We just haven't made any announcements about that." Iger added, "Given the popularity of the characters and given the popularity of the franchise, I don't think people should conclude there will never be another Avengers movie." Shortly after the film's premiere, Anthony Russo stated that he and Joe Russo did not have any plans for now to make any more Marvel movies after Endgame, but that they were not opposed to returning to the MCU in the future due to their wonderful relationship with Marvel Studios. Notes as depicted in the 2018 film Avengers: Infinity War, in which he was trapped at the end of the 2018 film Ant-Man and the Wasp. During the events of the 2012 film The Avengers. During the events of the 2013 film Thor: The Dark World, as depicted in the 2014 film Guardians of the Galaxy.
Please subscribe WikiAudio YouTube page below, click notification or bell icon to get future videos uploaded as instant notification, and write your valuable comment, suggestion, feedback to improve in future videos. Check out channel page to get more videos and share this channel to your friends and relatives.